Hey everybody, Long here, and welcome back. Today we're going to be reviewing this beautiful RF 1-300, and I'm here in Ocotillo Wells doing a really cool project with Brian Deegan and Travis Pastrana. Hope you guys enjoy. Let's check it out. I've been shooting with the RF 1-300 for 6 months now, and let me tell you, it is the best lens I've ever used. When it first released, I had it shipped to me on a commercial shoot, and that very first photo I took, I was blown away. I was just astonished at how sharp the image was. It's the sharpest lens I've ever used, and it's the sharpest lens that I have. It's sharper than my 7200, 24-70, 15-35. I have the new 24-105-28. Haven't tested it yet, a review will be coming, but out of all my lenses that I've used over the time, this is by far the sharpest. What I really love about this lens is its versatility. Moving from a 1-300 at a flick of a wrist is pretty phenomenal. Usually my setup is a 7200 with the 1-500 if I needed more range, but I don't have to worry about that now. I don't have to worry about switching lenses. Is this the right lens? It's getting a little light outside or anything like that. I noticed the 1-500 isn't as sharp at 500, but if you throw a 1x extender on this lens, it is sharp. The 1.4 extender autofocus perfectly fine. I didn't notice any drop in image quality with it on or off. I think Canon did a great job with the extender in their lens. If you're an RF user, you're gonna notice the size of this lens. It is ginormous, but it's like the old 300-28. So if you've used that in the past, it feels at home. It feels great in the hand. It's nice when you're tracking a subject. I don't really have an issue with it, except for maybe fitting in my camera bag, because I'm used to all the Canon RF lenses being more compact. But because this does shoot at 1-300, I don't need to bring as many lenses. I just need to bring a smaller set of lenses. And if I'm comfortable with the new 24-105-2.8, I'm just gonna need to bring two lenses with me, and it should be able to do everything I need, especially if I have that 1.4 extender with me to get those longer shots. The other thing is the weight with the camera and the lens. This is with the R3, and the 1-300 is 8 pounds. It's heavy, but it's not that bad. Everyone that's held this lens have said, oh, that's not bad for like what you're carrying and what it can do. I recently held my friend's 7200 with his Nikon D6. This is still lighter than that setup. So yes, it is a bigger lens. It is 8 pounds, but for what I do, it's not a big issue, especially if it's getting the job done. Overall, I love this lens. It is the best lens I've ever used or owned, and I'm so happy with this investment. Yes, it's a $10,000 price tag, but if you're a working photographer who's shooting team sports, action sports, dirt bikes, off-road vehicle, this lens is gonna give you so much versatility. You don't have to worry about as much if, oh, I gotta switch to one lens to another. This will cover probably 75% of what you're gonna do. So for 10 grand, and what this can do, it is a great investment in my opinion. Even if you're a hobbyist that really enjoy shooting, you know, team sports and you're just having fun out there, it's a great lens too. I don't recommend it for someone who's not a working photographer just because of the price tag on it. But if you are intrigued and you're wondering if it's a great lens, sharp lens, yes. This lens kills it. I recommend it to anybody who's willing to make that investment in this lens. Thank you guys for stopping by and watching this review of the RF 1-300. If you have any comments or questions that I didn't address, please add them in the section down below. I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Please hit that like, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.